Okay, so we have moved in closer to these nice people who are sitting at the end of the pool at the Covered Wagon RV Park.
One left.
Yeah.
He's coming back though.
Yeah, one left to get beverages. And we have established that they are not from Canada. Even though they are with their feet in the pool in the middle of winter.
It's very cold.
Yeah, right? I mean, I was thinking of ice skating. So anyway, yeah, tell me your story again, because I think people would love to know how you ended up sitting here with your feet in the water.
Well, I'm from Chicago and came here with a friend who owns a camper. And we put the camper here at this Covered Wagon Park about a month and a half ago. And it's just a little vacation spot for everybody to come and enjoy the time. And it's a great little campground, a great little community.
Right, it's a great location.
Yeah. And you guys have been here since March, April.
Well, we've been here since April.
Learning how to do laundry.
Well, yeah, you know, it's a fine art.
It's a fine art.
And so now we're sharing it. And I'd love to hear what you were saying about your mother lived on a sailboat.
Yeah, so I've been interested in this. I've been interested in the lifestyle of the full-time RV or full-time boat life. My mom and her husband owned a 32-foot catamaran sailboat in Daytona Beach, Florida, was where they're from, and they would every year take the boat down to the Florida Keys.
Nice.
To a place called Boot Key Harbor, which is in town of Marathon, Florida.
Nice.
And for only about $350 a month, you can rent a space in the harbor, and
On a buoy or an actual dock space?
On a buoy.
Nice.
But that included a pump out service for all your waste tanks and everything.
Wow.
And use of the shower facilities and laundry facilities.
That's pretty good. And laundry facilities. See, yep, that's what we're talking about.
There you go. Laundry is very important.
This is still on topic, people, just in case you think we're veering off the laundry subject.
Yeah. Well, it's interesting on how do you do your laundry and how do you use the bathroom, and those are the very important things people want to know about. I know that myself, I've done a lot of research into different types of campers, whether it's a Class A, B, or C.
Right.
And people even converting their vehicles. People live in their cars, and how do they use the bathrooms? And
yep.
You know, they go to either a grocery store, they go to a fitness center of some kind.
Yep.
Or they, you know, find just a place to park for the evening, and you know, whatever they can do it. But there's a lot of things they can do. But you know, on your topic of laundry, they've got those portable laundry machines. I think that you can, you know, my mom, I think, used a things like a foot pedal of some kind. I don't really remember.
Oh, wow,
but they had
really?
some sort of a portable unit that you could use it with.
Okay.
So I've seen videos online too where they use a bucket and a you know to do laundry.
Like instead of butter, you're turning your laundry. Turning your laundry. Okay. I was just suggesting going down to the river and beating them on rocks, but I kind of like the butter churning idea too. That's pretty good.
Where there's a will, there's a way. Right? So yeah, it's interesting to see how people live and people can accommodate to their lifestyles. It's very, very cool.
Yeah, we did a lot of research before starting on this, and there's just so much variety. And actually, the last video I was talking about the different ways of doing it with the different, you know, places where you're parked or the different unit you might have. And I actually did forget to mention that, you know, like a lot of the really big diesel pushers, they will have laundry on board, and it's often a machine that will do both. Like it
right.
only has the one opening, but you do your laundry and then somehow it magically turns into a dryer. But then you definitely need to be plugged in somewhere.
Well, you definitely, yeah, exactly. You have to have the expense of being plugged into, you know, into a facility, or if you're on a boat, they call it, you know, plugged into shore power.
Yep, exactly.
You know, on a boat, you can have a water maker where it draws in the ocean water and makes pure water for you.
Yep.
But there has to be a way of doing that. So if you're choose to do stealth camping, as they call it, you mm-hmm. know, and you're not in a campground itself, then you got to be inventive.
Yep. And actually, this pool looks pretty good too. We could have maybe done a little I know.
It's a little cold, but
I bring the soap, and then you just beat your feet up and down, and that might have done a good job. So, anyway, what's your name?
Justin,
thank you so much for talking
You're
with
welcome.
Me. It's
nice
really
to
nice
you.
To
yes.
meet you.
Yes.
You guys are fun.
I'm glad you guys are here.
Yes.
It's a fun vacation spot for us.
Yeah, you're out of the snow. and out of the cold for a little bit. And your friend, who I don't know, was he really going for drinks? I think he doesn't want. I think he doesn't want to be famous, even though he said he's happy to be on my.
Well, he left his phone behind, so he might have to do another video in a few minutes when he gets back.
Oh, that's always a good sign.
Yeah, that's right. You leave your phone behind. That's right.
That usually means you'll be back. Anyway, all right, well, I'm going to go back in there and check on my laundry, and I'll come back and talk to you guys some more.
Sounds great.
Thanks for your input on, the topic of laundry. That's from Tanya with love.
Bye-bye.
And maybe you could give the wave that I usually do.
Do you
Very
do
nice. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, I don't do the queen wave. I don't do the, like, crazy wave. But just that sort of friendly... And you're kind of from the Midwest.
I am.
So that's a
Chicago,
friendly. You guys are friendly and know how to wave.
Exactly.
So, okay, bye.
Thanks, bye.